free audio library.
Good afternoon, viewers. On this lesson, now we are going to talk about the new technology called the biogas. This biogas, we have about three steps that's passed through to make the gas. One, peel in any fruit or any fruit substance in it. Two, as the fruit substance gets to the tube, the inside tube, there's some small micro machines which pull out the carbon dioxide and make the fruit rotted. And on the next step, when the carbon dioxide is pulled from the plant, it goes into the tube. A tube where the gas is made. After it gets there, there's no air passing through that tube. Makes the carbon dioxide very hot, and the force and the pressure joins together on that point, which makes the carbon dioxide in an atmospheric pressure rise up to cook things even faster than the gas we use in the house. Biogas can be used to cook things faster than anything, especially it can be used to save money because it takes no money to fill it with gas, but on the first time it costs you a little expensive, so you have to work on it on the first time. On the second time, setting the new technology called the biogas is easy, but just some steps will be a little difficult, like the scoring steps. And when it gets to the technology side, make sure no machine, check all the machines before putting it into the biogas, else if there's a fault on one machine, it can cause the damage to a whole lot of things, and it can even cause explosion, because the atmospheric pressure gets there, it might blow up the machine to cause the gas to blow up, so it causes an explosion. And avoid flammable materials near to the biogas. Else, if you put flammable materials into the biogas, it might even blow up the whole entire system and get you into trouble. So please use the biogas very sense. And the second steps of another advice is that the biogas is very awesome, but be careful of the highway you use it. It's not everything you peel that goes off into it and makes the carbon dioxide rise. Things that don't have carbon dioxide are also not used to put in to enter the biogas steps, else which makes the fires go off. But things with acid can also be placed into the biogas to make the fire come in more hotter.
Okay, so my question says, you started by saying biogas can be made from fruit only. Explain that.
Biogas can't be made from fruit only. Also, substances with things that contain heat can also be put into.
Example.
Example is the orange.
Orange is a fruit.
Yes. And also something like your toilet. It also okay. has a little of carbon dioxide plus the acid.
Okay.
So it makes it a little seaweed.
Okay. My next question. Why can't we use other gases like hydrogen, oxygen and other stuff for burning?
We can use the hydrogen, alright, but the oxygen, we can't use it because oxygen supports burning but not create heat on its own.
Okay. Are you saying biogas is faster than the normal gas we use our homes, like the LPG?
Yes.
Why? Explain.
The reason why it's faster is that it has atmospheric pressure more than the gas we use in the house, and its carbon dioxide is generated from normally an atmospheric pressure heat which rises up to the gas burner, which makes it very hot.
So why do you think it will cost you in the initial setup of biogas?
It will cost you because the items used for the biogas are very expensive. For example, the carbon dioxide absorbers, they cost a lot.
Okay. So that makes it expensive, right?
Yes.
Okay. So what are the difficult steps in biogas setup?
One difficult step is the screwing step. Everybody knows screwing steps are simple steps, but in the biogas, there are some parts your hand will not reach because those parts are small. So in those times, you have to suffer a little before making those steps join together. There are some hard steps in the fixing that biogas.
Okay. Why will a damage to one machine cause damage to all?
Because if one machine gets spoiled, it connects to all machines. One machine is connected to all machines, which makes all the machines work together. So if one is damaged, the cause of it damage will spread to another one and make another damage of another material. For example, like your eye. One of your eye might hit by something and make it affected. And if you don't take care, it might affect the other one too.
Thank you. So in your own opinion, what will you do to stop such occurrences?
In my own opinion, I will seize out the gas and remove it. And screw all the steps I screw together, and remove out the broken machine, or let me say the problem with the machine, and fix it and put it back together to make the machine work back again. And that will.
Don't you think you need to do an independent kind of fixing so that when one is damaged, it doesn't affect all of them?
Yes, that's the cause. So,
why should we avoid putting flammable materials near biogas, and give examples of those flammable materials?
We should avoid putting flammable materials near the biogas because if we put flammable materials, it causes the atmospheric pressure to rise more up, which is not good for the gas burner to control it, which can cause explosion. And examples of those are the insecticide spray that we use in killing insects. If it's not taken, then it gets into it. The microbes can even get through the can and absorb the spray inside. Okay. Of the air and of the atmospheric air inside.
Okay. How do you peel them to avoid issues? How do you peel those fruits?
Sometimes if you peel the fruits, don't peel them too big, else it can chuck into the tube where the gas passes, and also the micro pickers can't pull all at the same time. So you have to peel it in a medium size.
Okay. My last question, where did you learn all this stuff from?
I learned it from my father's chemistry that he has been doing.
So you read the book, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I normally hack into his things.
All right.
Thank you, viewers, for watching OV. And please subscribe. Please. See you once again next time. Bye.
Free audio library.